Hey guys, and welcome back to Oxygen Not Included, Clay's Amazing Space Colony Adventure Extraordinaire. My name's Twitchi, and we are back in Twitchi's Tremendous Trojan, the rock that floats in space with about 14 duplicants in, I believe we've got, 14 according to the number up there. And one of the other problems we've got, because having duplicants in a rock is a problem, we have got overly qualified duplicants, which again doesn't sound like it's too much of a problem, but people, duplicants such as ZTech, they have demanded a certain level of living to their life, and unfortunately we cannot provide that for the moment. I didn't realize that this was going to be a cumulative effect, that no matter how, like, even if you take them away from their advanced mining job, that they actually still carry over the stress from having those levels of skills. So that is something that we need to work on. ZTech is a little bit stressed, and I would like to turn this room here into some sort of chill out area, somewhere that people can go and relax and have a beautiful time. Another thing I want to do is try and upgrade this airlock that we've got down at the bottom here. We are limited to 3 people running around and being in the outside to the left over there, and I would like to make that a little bit more accessible if at all possible. I'm also going to throw an oxygen vent in there with the idea in mind to try and get like some sort of overpressured unit in the airlock, so no matter what's going on either side of the door, when the door opens, the atmosphere from inside the airlock pushes outwards and keeps the pressure, keeps the atmosphere clean, keeps it pure. That's what we're after here. We don't really want like the polluted water or polluted oxygen or the hydrogen or any of the other nasty gases that can come from the great outside getting into our base, because that would just be bad. I mean, there are like situations where we can live with it. If there was a bit of polluted oxygen washes in, I mean, that's kind of okay because we have like cleaning systems everywhere. But it turns out we're going to have to rip down these exosuit docks that aren't directly connected to the checkpoint. I didn't realize this was something that we had to do, was to make sure they were actually touching the checkpoint. And obviously with the hole in the floor leading down to the water, that's not a thing we can do. So I'm going to quickly set up a few orders down below to try and get the pump back underneath the oil. Now, this is a good thing that we are running out of oil down below, because, you know, it we can get like the whole area drained and move on to a more sustainable area. But I do have a little hole in my base here, a hole that I need someone to fill up. You can see there is a mesh tower, and we are streaming polluted oxygen into the base. That, again, is not something that we want. Nighttime falls down, and everyone seems to be having a nice time and chilling out, but I'm starting to wonder why people who are stressed aren't going towards the massage desk. And it turns out it's because I didn't build the ladder yet. But yeah, that's okay. Another thing that I've noticed is that I don't actually know how these anti-entropy hydrogen-powered cold devices work, or even why I can't put that door up there. You see how it's an I presume it's something to do with the walls and stuff. But yeah, I don't know how the anti-entropy thing works. I used to think that we just like pump some hydrogen into it and then you get cold hydrogen out or something like this. But it turns out that is also not the idea. What actually happens is you pump hydrogen in and it lowers the temperature of the area around you. Now, this kind of sounds a little bit naff, a little bit not useful. That is, of course, until you remember that the temperature shift plates are a thing. And we're going to use these to try and move some of the cold down towards the cold tank down there. That would be a good idea. I suppose it was technically moving the heat up towards the anti-entropy device up the top there. But, you know, we've just got to try and work with these things. Now, I've put some holes down to put the temperature shift plates in, but I've made a terrible mistake, and we're about to watch the terrible mistake come around and bite me. Obviously, putting holes in the top of a water tank means that you are vulnerable, but I did also remember that, you know, I put down a whole bunch of new storage containers on the left over there, and then I told them just to take everything, and of course, that would then lead to them trying to put ice into them, and that's a bad plan, so we need to try and work that out. Okay, I'm watching water starting to flow, and slowly the idea is percolating in my head that might not be a great thing. But here we go, back to the relaxation area. Put down a little bit of a wire there to make sure that it works out. Man, my camera work is all over the place. I'm not staying anywhere for long enough to actually give a proper commentary, but that's fine because we get to watch these guys build these temperature shift plates, and we're going to spend the majority of our time watching this cold water tank, because if you actually watch, the time it takes for them to make those temperature shift plates is actually incredibly long. I didn't realize when I started this. Also, don't do level 9 priorities. I should be aware of this by now, but for some reason I am not. I keep doing it, realizing my problem, and then going around and correcting that issue. We're also going to spend a lot of time hooking up hooking up a lot of normal metals, going through the refining process there. At some point, we should actually probably make a better refinery. But I've also noticed that the wiring system is a little bit naff here. We've got like one wire just going into a different area, and I've got like that power corridor down below not being useful. So I go around and do some things to hopefully try and fix that. I actually make a little bit of a mistake, but you know, that will come out and show itself to us at some point. So we're watching Zedtech here, and you can tell by like the look of him that he's not an entirely happy bunny. I used to think that it was because he was ill, but the more I tried to make him healthy, the less it would actually help. I took out that mesh tile underneath to drop the ice into the water in some sort of like hope that the water is more thermally conductive and can get the heat into the ice quicker. That's my plan anyway. So yeah, back to watching these guys building the temperature shift plates. We're gonna spend a lot of time here, a lot of time indeed. And I realized that I made a big error by not using local materials. So to try and save just little bits of time, I'm gonna go through and turn that into the local materials, the granite indeed. A few nice places to swap over, and I'm thinking that the double wide areas might have a little bit better sort of throughput, if you will. That's the word that I'm looking for. Okay, so we've got about double the amount of footage that I would actually like. So I've moved forward to the point where I've started noticing that we've got little bits of polluted water dropping into the water tank there. Literally only about half a cycle or something like that forwards. And immediately I'm like, oh no, action stations, we have got to try and fix this. So I start off by putting a whole layer of tiles above. I very quickly realise this is actually a terrible idea, but it's a good first panic session. So we're going to do that. Also, thankfully, because there's not too much polluted water dropped in and the fact that it's got no germs in it, it's not a big problem. So all we need to do is tell them to mop the area up and that should work. Now, you may have noticed that there is a duplicant. I think it's Mad Frank. I might be wrong there. It might be Brum. Up to the top right. He is stuck. I haven't realized this yet because as you can see, it was all happening off to the side of my screen and I didn't actually see that because I was too busy looking at the polluted water there. With nighttime falling onto the colony, I take a little moment to have a look around and try and remember exactly what it is I'm doing everywhere. And of course, one of the things that springs to mind is, of course, we've got a steam vent off there. The printer says it's ready to print something, and I don't have any room for duplicates, so we can now get some, like, food. The printer can now make all sorts of different things, food, resources, as well as duplicates. So I take full advantage of that. The next day comes on strong, and I'm hoping that the duplicates are going to go ahead and do this music box here, because I think that's a nice thing there. And of course, the plastic ladder being in place makes the massage chamber a worthy area for people to hang out. And we've got a little bit of a problem where duplicants aren't actually going around and doing all the cable strengthening that is required. And of course, with the addition of the two massage tables both doing 240 each, and the maximum of most of the first level wiring being able to take is 1,000, I mean, those two tables on their own take over half the allowance, if you will. So I'm noticing that a lot of the things that we're trying to dig here are actually minor only jobs. So I'm gonna try and put another way around for people to get to it, and that immediately pays dividends. Though I've started noticing people are starting to have a little bit of a messy time over there, but I thought that was Mad Frank on the right, but now that I'm watching the footage back, that's not actually how it went down, and I have no idea where that happened. That is a worrying in the strongest degree. Somewhere in my base, there is a whole bunch of mess out there, and I don't know where it is. So, you can see that my build orders are slowly getting more and more trapped, though thankfully I left a little bit of a wide open area for people to be able to drain liquids and stuff like that in there. But I'm really, really worried about the amount of polluted water. You can see that there is ices that I have left behind. Those are mainly polluted ices, and I am super worried about what to do with them. I'm slowly coming to the conclusion that I'm gonna need to make little dividing walls everywhere. Not just so that we can like keep track of the ice and keep it all into nice places and stuff, but so that people can get down into the gap and start building the thermal shift plates, because without those thermal shift plates, the heat ain't going anywhere. So I'm noticing that my stress just keeps on climbing, and I haven't quite figured out why yet, though I've also noticed we're about to lock people down into the hole. Thankfully, I watched this in time, got the person to move out, and then put down a couple of ladders, so hopefully that is a thing that never happens again. One thing that I have got, somehow, is that I've got the red alert priority on a lot of my tools, and we really need to sort that out. Decided that I really wanted to have a look at the music. Everybody ran away, but thankfully subs came along to show us the beautiful times were still being had there. Watching people master their jobs, and I'm starting to think, where do I actually want Zed Tech to be doing stuff? Because now he has mastered the entirety of his favourite jobs. I'm wondering what job he actually wants to do. Now, the reason that we are giving him a wide cross-section of jobs to be done is because things like exosuit engineer and space cadet, they need multiple masteries of jobs before you can start taking them on. Okay, so I've put down a whole bunch of orders for the hot water tank, mainly in some sort of hope to try and get down and start putting the thermal shift plates back in place without actually leaving ourselves vulnerable. You can see that the upright walls there actually enclose the space where any polluted water should fall, though I have noticed just above the one on the left, if you go up like 7 blocks or something, there was a whole load of polluted ice that I obviously had not noticed. So the next thing I want to do is move my main toilet. You can see that there is a toilet in the main thoroughfare for leaving this base, and honestly, that is a terrible place to have it. You know what would work better there? An airlock. So we're going to try and move the stuff down here. The first thing we need to do is change this horrifically carbon dioxide filled hole into somewhere where people can live. We do that by putting an air vent in the floor, and now we're working on getting all the plumbing away. And now that they're working on the jobs, I've put a slightly lower priority job to destroy the toilets up above. And I'm hoping that my man Tommy can come along with his plumber skills and fix that. I might even have to start putting like lots of people's jobs as plumbers, just so they can all have that skill. Being able to open out the water at any point would be a wonders. I'm gonna do a little jump here because they're just gonna do this same thing for, I think, 3 cycles. 188 to 189, even the morning of 190. Yes, indeed, all they did was go around and work on the cold water tank, putting the thermal shift plates in place. And today I was like, right, fair enough, we're gonna have to start putting other things at slightly higher priorities, but putting them up relative to the thermal shift plates so we can start figuring out how to get people in and out. One thing that I also noticed on the massage tables is the fact that there was this public setting that I didn't realize was actually there. It turns out you have to set them to public rather than just waiting for them to turn up, which I'm fine with that. I think that's a good thing, but it really needed to have been explained at some point, because I was just expecting my duplicants to turn up, and then when they didn't, I set it to the individual duplicant, because, you know, public just kind of gets lost in the list of 14 people, and it wasn't until I went looking for someone halfway down the list that I went, oh, what's this public button all about? Okay, so the water is warming up, and this is why we are really working on this cold area here, because we need to start dealing with the incoming dirty water. We're actually producing more dirty water than we can deal with the current system, and that is entirely on the cooling rate being a bit of a letdown there. I'm beginning to think about expanding the cold water tank to the right a little bit, and I am suddenly noticing that people are coming all the way out here. Ruby is the person we've noticed, but they've come all the way out here to try and deliver some liquefiable items, polluted ice no less, to the storage compactor way on the other side of the asteroid. And I am worried. Look at the temperature there. I know that this stuff melts at somewhere about minus 10, and he gets all the way across to minus 13. I'm like, you know what? That's kind of not what I want to do. So I sit there and think a little while we watch Brum go through and repair and fix, in fact, the water pump over here. Now, I was trying to figure out how low we can do it, because you can see that there is a ladder, an extra ladder that needs to get built, so we can go down one further than it can technically reach right now. So I set out a whole bunch of stuff, because obviously the lower down we put the pump, the less we have to worry about it. Though we are trying to completely drain this area out, so maybe we can get some of our resources back from the flooded out area. That would be pretty nice. Noticing that the massage area is filling up with carbon dioxide, we'd like to fix that, so we put an air flow tile over the top of the air vent, and Zed Tech getting down to some funky beats. Oh yeah. All right, the toilets have moved and people are using them. That's fine. We set the public for everyone on there, and people are having a good food. Sorry, the public on the massage table there for everyone. And I start having a look at this this oxygen pump, because oxygen pipe, sorry, because obviously if we're going to have an airlock over here, we need to have some exosuits. exosuits are the breath of life when it comes to being outside of the base after all, so having some exosuits in our airlock sounds like a great idea. I would like to have it so that anywhere outside of this sandstone biome, if you will, people have to use exosuits, which probably means we're going to have to work on some of the other areas to try and make them a little nicer, like the airlock on the left needs more exosuits to be available or something like that, but that's fine. Now, thankfully, we have the like prioritization done by proximity little checkbox on. I believe that's in the priority overlay menu, which means when our duplicants woke up this morning, they were like, look at all these gas pipes that need laying, look at all these exosuit things that need doing, look at all these areas in the base that just need fixing. And I was very much in agreement that needed doing. I also note that there's a little bit of a gas pipe we can't get to there, no problem. But of course, now we have an interesting thing where we've got a checkpoint up and running and no exosuits to allow people out. Watch how long it takes me to realize. But also, where was our plumber? What happened there? A whole bunch of water got dropped on the floor because we ripped down some pipes. I don't understand why that was a thing. Surely the plumber should have prioritized that as their job. I don't know. Well, anyway, with the completion of the gas pipe of the oxygen, it starts to flow, making sure that all the pipes are up and running over here. And at some point, we're going to be able to like connect the other water pump back up, the other liquid pump, sorry, back up, and that will be beautiful. Looking back at our water tank here, you can see that the temperature is getting pretty close. I've set it to start pumping at 20, and we're at like 22, something like that. As I get more and more confident with the temperature shift plates when they finally get connected up, we will drop that temperature down immensely. Okay, so we need to try and figure out how to power these exosuit docks. That's nice and easy. We just grab it from one of the power transformers that we moved around early on. And I'm noticing how much polluted dirt is building up at the farm, because a lot of food is just getting left to waste for some reason. And I'm not sure what is going with that, but we will try and figure that out maybe some other day, because right now we've got this to worry about. So with Landstrider partying the night away, I've got a very interesting situation actually arising with the airlock that we're just building on the right. Obviously the exosuit checkpoint has been put up, but we don't actually have any exosuits in there at the moment. So unbeknownst to me actually playing the game, these guys can't make it out through the right-hand door. I don't know why it didn't occur to me that having a checkpoint down without any way of like satisfying the checkpoint's requirements wouldn't like make a problem. No, I just didn't think about it. So we set up a whole bunch of requests there, and despite the fact that we have exosuits on the floor, we still have to wait for new ones to get made. That's no a big problem, but I kind of was hoping that would be done a little quicker, just because they're so close. Even though the priority was quite low, I was kind of expecting them to just get done because of the proximity thing. But with people taking the suits over to the right, we can see that people are also, or duplicants, are also starting to make their escape off to the right, off to go do farming, clean up everything. And also I've noticed that my wiring is very bad here, very, very bad. In fact, it was causing a little bit of an overheat, and that's what made me notice. I was like, why is this a thing? There shouldn't be any problem there. You can see the damaged wire top middle of the screen there. Thankfully, just a few quick cleavy clicks and a little bit of a red alert later, we were able to not completely fix it, but stop it being a problem and then order up the fix for later. So one of the things I'm noticing are, one, there are gaps in the oxygen flow. I'm not overly keen on that, so I start by trying to like drop down the numbers to see whether we can set a new equilibrium where it just keeps on pumping and the electrolyzer isn't at max pressure all the time. But another thing I'm noticing as well is people picking up that ice that I dropped earlier to put it back into the storage bit. Yeah, that was not overly useful. And back at the cold water tank, I can see that the temperature shift plates aren't actually doing a thing. Every time that I quickly flick on the temperature overlay, the bubble of heat, if you will, gets bigger and bigger, which sounds like it's a bad thing, but it's actually like spreading it out over a wider area and is slowly making its way towards the anti-entropy hydrogen thermal device, or whatever it's actually called. I will actually learn its name one day, but today is not the day for that. Mainly because the biggest problem that has just presented itself to me, we appear to be running out of oxygen in the base, which is not a great way to be spending your time if as a colony manager. You want your colonies to be able to breathe and do wondrous things. So on our way of finding algae, because algae is the quickest way we can make oxygen, on our way to find algae, we're also going to get a whole bunch of slime, and that's going to go down to the slime distillers and make us out some more algae so we can get lots and lots and lots of oxygen. That would be amazing. That will be great. I'm just going to hope that these guys do their stuff in the background. One thing that I'm slowly coming to terms with, as well as watching the fact that the oil is being pumped out, is the fact that not as much oxygen is making it over to the second set of exosuits as I would like. And that is mainly due to the air pump, the air vent, directly after the first set of exosuit docks. Yes, so that's a little bit worrying. That means that at least half of what gets past the first set of exosuits goes straight to the vents before getting sent on to the next lot. So that means half the oxygen that we're producing is just being vented into the base, which is a good thing because we're currently running out of oxygen, but it's not where I wanted it to go. So that's a little bit disappointing. You can see, despite the fact that we have been pumping pretty solidly for a little while now, the water tank is quite a low of a level, and dude's going around doing some pretty major tidying up there. I'm highlighting the priority of the access ways, if you will, because I want to get down and really get to those temperature shift plates, and all it nearly needs is a couple of ladders just to let people down. You can see that I put roofs over their head despite the fact that they've not actually built them. This is a bad thing. This is something that I need to actually prioritize much higher than the actual digging. Totally done in the wrong order there. And I'm just quickly adding up some numbers to see whether we can actually extend this out to a double one, but I'm afraid that is going to have to wait for next time, because I am going to say thank you very much for joining me for this adventure, ladies and gentlemen. I will see you next time when we're going to finish the temperature shift plates. We're actually going to double up the oxygen production. I'm looking around at the moment thinking about where we can put this. Let me tell you, what you're seeing on screen right now is not what I end up doing. That's just first thoughts and plans and plays and experiments and trying to get things sorted out in the right way. But I will see you next time when we're going to do a whole host of things, just make the base a little bit nicer, make the oxygen better, and just make everything nicer for everyone. So I'll see you then when we're going to do that. Bye!